7 divided by, so the bandwidth is 200 plus, so the delay is 2000, so 2000. So now we can, using the calculator, we can find out this value. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 divided by 200 plus delay is 2000 equal to 5200 into 256 equal to 1331 2000. So the value 1331 2000. Okay, so in R2 router we have two direct connected network. One is 192.100.200.0 and another one is 150.150.100.0. so in this network we can calculate the metric value. Now in this network is another direct connected network. In this network we can calculate the metric value using the bandwidth and delay. So this network can be connected through which port? Serial 0/1. So in this port we can assign the bandwidth and delay is 400 and delay 4000 milliseconds. So the direct connected network, so the direct connected network for R2 is 150.150.100. So 150.150.100.0 /30. So R2 router can be connected to this network through which port? Serial 0/1. So in this port we can assign the bandwidth and delay. So using this bandwidth and delay we can calculate the metric value for this network 150.150.100.0. So 256 into 10 power 7 divided by, so the bandwidth is 400 plus delay is 4000 equal to, so using the calculator we can calculate the value 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Okay, so divided by, so bandwidth is 400 equal to plus delay is 4000 now into 256, so the value is 7424000. So 7424000. Yeah, 7424000. Okay, next indirect connected network. Indirect connected network is 192. So indirect connected network is 192.200.50. So 192.200.50.0/30. Okay, so now we can calculate the metric value for this network. So R2 router direct connected network is 192 and 150. So 182, this network can be connected through which port? Serial 0/0. So in this port we can assign the bandwidth and delay. So using this bandwidth and delay we can calculate the metric value for this network. And this is an another direct connected network. So this direct connected network is connected through which port? Serial 0/1. So in this port we can assign the bandwidth and delay. So using this bandwidth and delay we can calculate the metric value for this network. Next 192.200.50. So this is an indirect connected network. So this network can be learned by R2, means we can calculate the advertised distance and feasible distance. So first of all, R2 router can reach this network, means through which port they can reach. So through R2 router to R3, through which port serial 0/1. So in this port we can assign the bandwidth and delay. Next, R3 router can be connected to R4 router, through which port serial 0/1. So through this port only they can reach this network. So R2 to R3 and R3 to we can reach this network. So we can calculate the bandwidth and delay of serial 0/1 and bandwidth and delay of serial 0/1. So this two bandwidth and delay we can use to calculate the average distance and feasible distance. So first of all, we can calculate the average distance. Average distance means we don't use the metric value of source. So this is a metric value of source. We don't use this, and we can use this one, this metric value bandwidth and delay only. So to find out the average distance, so 256 into 10 power 7 divided by 10 power 7 divided by 500 plus 500 plus 3000 equal to, so using calc we can calculate 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so divided by bandwidth is 500. So 500 plus 3000, so into 256, so the metric value is 5 8 8 5 8 8 0 0 0. So this is an advertised distance AD. Okay, next we can find out the feasible distance. So in feasible distance we can take in the source value also. So R2 can reach this network through which port serial 0/1 and serial 0/1. So we can use this bandwidth and delay and this bandwidth and delay. So we can find out first of all we can find out the average distance. Using this bandwidth and delay we can find out the average distance of this network. Next we can calculate the feasible distance using these two bandwidth, that is using source value to find out the feasible distance. So using this bandwidth and delay and this bandwidth and delay. So if it is more than one bandwidth, means we can compare the bandwidth, which one is minimum, we can take in that bandwidth and we can add all the delay values. So 400 500, which one is minimum? 400. So we can take in this bandwidth and delay 4000 plus 3000. So 256 into 10 power 7 divided by 400 plus the delay value is 4000 plus 3000. So 4000 plus 3000. So we can calculate this value. See, calculator. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 divided by 400 plus delay value is 4000 plus 3000 into 256. So the value is 819 2000 819 2000 819 2000.